谢谢大家。我会使用中文来进行演讲。So I will switch to English to deliver, to Chinese to deliver my presentation. Good morning and welcome to my session. And now open source is really a buzzword globally. And also we can see a lot of implication brought by the open source. And also open source has become a talk of the town in China as well. And for Tencent, we are really at the front line of technology upgrading in China. And in the recent years, we have also accumulated a lot of experience. We learned a lot of lessons from the past several years. So here, I'd like to share with you our best practice and also the roadmap. So my name is Du Junping. And I'm from the Apache community, and also I'm in charge several tasks in Tencent open source, in Tencent cloud, and also I'm the witness of the growth of cloud and also open source in Tencent and also in China. A brief history of Tencent open source, and basically it is from internal to external, so 7 years or 8 years ago, we began to identify some key projects, and also we run a screening on open source project, and we identify several that is really amazing. And 2 to 3 years ago, we began to focus on open source compliance, and we began to look at the compliance procedures, and we really take off. And also since last year, we began to look at the community openness and also governance, and also the integration of the community with businesses. So here is about the Tencent open source project, the status quo. So from several years ago, we began to identify key projects, and currently on the GitHub page, we have more than 70 projects, and also we have more than 600 contributors, and it has covered a lot of industries and also areas, including security, gaming, IoT, mini program, and also other developing tools. And they are based on our immense data and also application scenarios. So for all of these open source projects are much welcomed by our contributors. And also you can see the number of stars is more than 220,000. And also we pay attention to our soft capability building. So for instance, we look at Apache's analysis on the healthiness of all these projects. So within a project, we will look at the number of commits and also the frequency of release. And apart from that, we will also look at the participation level of external contributors for in terms of PR and also in terms of issue, and in order to check whether the project is still in good health. And we use a lot of data analysis algorithm and in order to promote all these open source projects. And apart from our own resources, also we now focus on better collaboration with international communities. For instance, with Apache, with OpenStack, and also with the Linux Foundation, we have formed a very close cooperation model, including MariaDB, and also the foundations under the umbrella. And we are the platinum sponsor for Linux, for Apache, for MariaDB, and also for OpenStack. And apart from providing capital, we also contributed a lot of codes and also projects for Linux. We devoted TCL and also TAS, teaser and TAS. So one is about microservice, and another is service discovery architecture. We donate these projects to Linux. And also we have Angel, which is a deep learning framework, to Linux AI Foundation. And apart from these project donation, We also collaborate with Spark Link of Apache. We do a lot of open source donation. We donate a lot of patch. And also, we are the first one in Hadoop community and also other influential community to do release. And we're really proud of ourselves. And also in KBM community for Tencent Cloud, we also contribute a lot of patches as well. And I think in terms of absolute number, we are number one. And also for MariaDB, we also have four core features accumulated, and we have donated these four features to MariaDB as well. And behind all these open source results, actually we have a whole supporting mechanism. So for instance, in structure-wise, we have the open source office, who is responsible for the open source business overall. And also we have the alliance under this office and in charge of external collaboration and, for instance, the matchmaking with our external organizations. And also we have the compliance and also legal fair office and in order to guarantee the full compliance. And also we have our own platform to guidance and in order to make sure that the open source business can run smoothly. So based on our past several years of experience, we now generate a roadmap of Tencent open source. So you can refer to this slide. Before, we work in silo and we work in isolation, and now it is a cross-office, cross-department open source collaboration. But this is still internally, and also in the future we will have the open governance and also open community governance. So basically there will be three stages or three steps. First of all, we will have internal open source collaboration, and we will identify the key projects, and we will galvanize the company level resources. And also secondly, the second step is about external codes open, and we will collaborate with external organizations to do optimization in terms of code design and also to diversify the application scenarios. And also for the third stage, yes, the so-called open community governance stage. So within this stage, we will promote open source community, or we will do a total donation to a third party. And by this way, we can contribute to a bigger size open source community. And also, we will have the community leadership cultivation run in parallel as well, and to realize better resource allocation. And also apart from this open source, we have some key focus, for instance, in terms of tests. And also we will focus on virtualized kernel development, and also we will look at a private cloud, and also hardware design open source. And in terms of cloud native, we will focus on Docker and also Kubernetes, for instance, KubeCon and also CNCF community. And also we will focus on MySQL progress, and also we will look at the memory database, and also to look at a real-time database, and also the HTAP, the new technology from direction. And also in big data and artificial intelligence, we will look at Flink, and also the future direction for development, and also like the integration of different cloud technologies, and also the integration of big data and also artificial intelligence. We will look at the basics and also application of AI and also the open source of AI. And we will have multiple focuses, and hopefully we can find a way out. And also for the midware, we will also look at a microservice fracture architecture as well. And just like Ya Cheng has said, we have devoted a lot of R&D resources and also technical support to edge computing and IoT computing, and we have four major directions. And another thing is Tencent have our own mini program ecosystem, and we will open source more tools to give support for mini program development and also design. And lastly, I'd like to say that to have a successful open source, we need to have innovative technology and also an open, healthy community. And for the third is the implementation and also application of a technology and also project. But behind that, the key asset is always people. So we need to uphold the mindset featured by innovation, by sharing spirit, and also by open and transparency, and also a win-win attitude. And I sincerely hope that we can enjoy a rosy picture for the open source, not only in China, but also